We don't celebrate Christmas at all. And this year is the first time where no elements of Christmas will be in our house. And to be honest, I'm super excited about it. And before you get mad, let me explain. Hello and welcome to Adventure All the Way. I'm Emma and I'm a home educating mum of three from the UK. If you're new here, welcome. Here we talk all things neurodivergent, home educating, family life in a family of five. And if you are a returning viewer or subscriber, thank you so much for coming back. So, I'm pagan, which means that Christmas is not my holiday. Christmas is a Christian festival, and I celebrate a festival just 4 days beforehand, that is called Yule. Now, Yule is a celebration of the winter solstice, which usually falls between the 20th and 22nd of December. And it's like Christmas in many ways, and the origins of the traditional Christmas that we celebrate now, many of them have roots in Yule, and a lot of the things that you would deem as being Christmassy actually can be traced back to pagan origins. Obviously the religious aspects are not the same, but things like a tree in your house, a wreath on your door, all of that sort of thing, they can be traced back to paganism. It is said that the Christian church adopted many of the pagan customs to encourage people to convert to Christianity, to make it easier for people to convert to Christianity, and then overall just to make a seamless transition from one religion to another. So there'll be many things that I say that this is what we do on Yule that you will find very, very similar. So let me know in the comments the things that you notice that are similar about Yule or to Christmas in your household. So one of the pagan folk tales is about the Holly King and the Oak King, and I'll give you a brief description because this sets the story for one of the things that we acknowledge and celebrate on Yule. So it is said that both at the winter solstice and the summer solstice, there are two halves of one whole, one called the Oak King and one called the Holly King. They're supposed to be the same energy, the same spirit, but one, funnily enough, wears a crown of holly and the other wears a crown of oak. One is the ruler of the dark times, one is the ruler of the light times. The Oak King rules the time from winter solstice to summer solstice, and then the Holly King rules from summer to winter. And on winter solstice, they fight, and the Holly King, he loses and he dies, ready to be reborn again and take his rest. And he's reborn again at later point, and he comes back and fights for the summer solstice. And that's when the Oak King dies, and then so on and so forth. So we celebrate the Holly King and his hard work. We will bring holly into our home to honor his hard work over the dark times, which is from the summer solstice to the winter solstice as the days are getting shorter. We will honor this time. This is really important to us, and we love the story behind it. In fact, when this is the first year that my children do not believe in. So this year, they still wanted to do the traditions that we have kept over the years, we've had over the years, and they wanted to keep those. But we have just simply transitioned them to the Holly King on Yule instead. So on Yule Eve, well, before Yule, sorry, we will bring in a tree. We will bring in a real Yule tree. We'll go to a Christmas tree farm nearby, and we will purchase our Yule tree. And every year we go there, the people who own the Christmas tree nursery go, "Ah, Yule tree!" Like, yes, we're come here to get our Yule tree, not our Christmas tree. So they're always really excited that they've got someone who's coming to get the tree for a different, re slightly different reason. And they're really, really nice. You get to pick your own tree, and they cut it down for you. It's very cool. So it starts off with getting that. Now, the spiritual aspect behind bringing the tree in is that every living thing has a soul. So it's otherwise known as animism. And trees and bugs and plants and flowers all have a soul. So and in a way you would call it spirits or fairies. So they have I suppose they have every tree has a soul, and then every tree also has a spirit, or maybe a fairy type thing that lives in it, that lives it, cares for it, and so on and so forth. So you bring the tree in, and those spirits that take care of those trees in that time also come into your home. That's the story behind it. So we will hang things like cinnamon sticks or dried fruit decorations or other things like that, like chocolates, candy canes, that sort of thing, onto the tree as offerings for those spirits that we've brought into our home. So the story is you invite the spirits in for the month of December to shield them from the winter and help them develop a winter store of the energy from the food. So they take the energy from the food that you have placed onto the tree, and then when the tree goes, they go as well, and they go back out into the world. And our story behind the Holly King is that the Holly King will leave us gifts to say thank you for the hospitality to his spirits over the month of December. So once we've got our Yule tree, we obviously decorate it and we decorate the house. We tend to go for very specific colours. That will be gold, silver, red or green. We don't tend to go outside of that. The ornaments that are not, say, like dried oranges or things like that, they will be very rustic. So they will be very simple and very rustic. We'll have a lot of animals. We have hedgehogs and owls and squirrels and things. We will have things that are synonymous of winter. So there won't be any angels or anything like that. You might be hearing my dog snoring in the background. We have angels or anything like that. We don't have Santa or Rudolph, reindeers or anything like that. We have, as I said, like some animals, and we have like some stockings and jumpers and things like that, and then just plain baubles. We'll have a lot of stars because the winter solstice is about the sun returning, and of course the sun is a star, but we tend to go for more rounded designs than the typical pointy star, if that makes sense. And actually we are going to make some more Yule type decorations over the month of December that look more like suns. And things like holly and things like that, we're gonna make more things like that to go on the tree so it feels more Yule-y rather than Christmassy. So once we've got our tree and we've decorated it, we do some Yule crafts or Christmassy crafts. They're essentially the same thing, but I'll be very discerning about which ones I give them. So I wouldn't necessarily do Santas and reindeer. I would do things like holly, a sunshine. We do lots of sun catchers and things like that, just to... Like, if they wanted to do Christmassy things, then we would do them, but they don't. They want to do Yule things, so I'm just... What I present to them is Yule things. Otherwise they go, oh, that's not really very Yule-y, is it? So then when it comes to the evening before Yule Eve, if you will, we will do the same thing. Our stockings will be hung up, and everyone's got really cool ones this year. Let me just show them to you. So I got these from Amazon, and they were quite pricey. They were like $9.99 each. But they're so sweet. There's Charles's. I just grabbed three and they just happened to be the children's ones. They look like the proper knitted stockings. And then we've got Bessie. Bessie is actually a nickname. Her name's actually Elizabeth, but she didn't want Elizabeth on there, so she's got Bessie. And then we've got Albert. His is green as well. Mine is green and Phil's is red because we've got in age order and I'm the oldest. So mine's green, Phil's is red, Charles is green, Bessie's is red, Albert's is green. So they'll all be hung up. All be hung up, and there'll be a pattern, which we like because we are a neurodiverse household and patterns make us all happy in this one. In this house, I know some people don't necessarily care about them, but we definitely do. Patterns make us happy. So we'll hang up our stockings. They usually get hung up throughout in the month of December as decorations in the living room, just where we have our living room altar. I don't think I've ever shown you that, so I will definitely show you that once it's decorated for Yule. I think I might have shown it. I don't know if I posted it on Instagram for when we decorated for Mabon and Samhain. I can't remember now, but I will show that to you if I haven't already. Like, I'll show you when we've winterized it, because it's all very autumnal at the moment. As you can see, I'm very autumnal today as well. We usually hang them near there, and then the children will be putting things out for the Holly King to have when he comes, before he goes for his fight, before he comes to say thank you to us. And obviously they don't actually believe it's the Holly King, But we're kind of just playing along with it now. We've just decided we're going to play along with it. They said, you know, we want to just play it like it's a game. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to play the game. Yes, they haven't decided if they're going to leave things out for him, like the typical like food and drink. But they're kind of thinking maybe they'll make gifts for him. So like they might use our clay. We've got some coloured air dry clay. I think if you've seen my use my shorts, see my shorts or my Instagram posts, the volcanoes that we made, that's the air drying clay. I'll link it in the description. It's really, really good. It did take a long time to dry, but it was worth it. It's really nice. And it's kept its shape, it's kept its colour. So they did say something about making him small gifts like ornaments, and leaving those out as an offering. So that's very sweet. But yes, I'm not sure where we're gonna go with that. They usually decide nearer the time. And then in the morning, it'll be very much like a Christmas morning in someone in a Christian household or in a Christmas celebrating household. They come in to us before the sun rises, and this is very, very specific. Like we will wake them up if they're not awake, to be awake before the sun rises. And of course, this time of year, that is not difficult. I'm filming this at 5:45 at night, and it's been pitch black for at least an hour. So, it's not hard, is it, to really wake up before the sun this time of year? They will even like Charles, who's almost a teenager, I will wake him, and then they will open their stockings. Usually Albert's awake anyway, so he'll wake them usually. And or I will if they're not already awake. And then we'll open our stockings, and then as the sun begins to rise, we will all stand by the window and we will sing pagan songs. A lot of them are quite similar. So instead of like God rest ye merry gentlemen, it's God rest ye merry pagan folk. You might have heard it on TikTok if you follow creators who, if you've got any pagan talk on your TikTok or something like that. So we have certain like songs that we'll sing, sorry. Another thought was believed that you kept a flame going because the flame would encourage the light back. So we have an LED candle that we place in the window. And we've got a lot of LED candles this year because we bought them for the pumpkins at Samhain. So the children have said they want LED candles in their windows as well to encourage the sun back, saying, look, there's light, come back. And then we'll sing, we'll have our candles on. And then we'll open, if we haven't already opened our gifts, we'll open our gifts. We tend to have like quite a special breakfast, and usually it's like a continental breakfast. So there'll be croissant, there'll be pain au chocolat, and there'll be some meats like salami, prosciutto. I don't know if I said that right. If you speak Italian, correct me. If I did it wrong. Things like that, and then we might have some scrambled eggs, like just, you know, maybe pancakes, like anything like that, really. Just something a bit special that we wouldn't usually do. And then we will take our dogs for a walk because we take our dogs for a walk every day, so we'll go for a nice walk. usually somewhere where there's going to be wildlife because we will feed. I will. So we'll take bird seed to feed animals with, to leave out for birds. It's really important for us on Yule to honor Mother Nature and to give offerings to her animals and to her as well. We would refer to her as Gaia. And then after we've had a walk, we'll come back and I'll start cooking. We would usually have kind of like a late ish lunch. It would probably be maybe like 1, so I'll start cooking, and we might have we don't have turkey or anything like that because we don't really like it, so we'll usually have roast pork or roast duck depending, and we usually alternate duck pork, but this year we just decided we're going to have roast chicken, just because we haven't had chicken and haven't had a roast chicken in a really long time. We eat a lot of chicken, but we haven't had a roast chicken in ages. So I think we're going to go with a roast chicken. We might change our minds and have duck, but I'm not sure. I think everyone likes roast chicken, whereas I'm not sure Albert does like roast duck. I think sometimes he's not a fan. So I think we're just gonna go with the roast chicken and just kind of make it a bit fancy, like do like a glaze or something on it. And then we have roast potatoes, we'll have various vegetables, we will have Yorkshire puddings, lots of gravy, and then pudding. We will usually, if I can find a free from one in Tesco, that is dairy free because I'm dairy free, then I'll get a Yule log, but usually I can't. So we have made them in the past, but they're usually quite difficult. Yule number two. So we tend to have maybe something like a Christmas pudding, but actually I say that, like last year we had a Christmas pudding and it's still in the cupboard. So actually what we're having for pudding, that I know that we're definitely having for pudding this year, is a cake that's been being made by one of my best friends, Angie. As I mentioned, I mentioned in one of my shorts about budget Christmas, we are on a really, really strict budget this year. There's lots of things that we are going without, and I was speaking to my friend about this, my friend Nadia, about this, and she's so, so kind. She's just such a generous and giving person. She said to me, I'm gonna do you a hamper of things that I can afford to give to you that you maybe are gonna go without because you can't afford it. And I was like, oh. And I'm not very good at receiving gifts, but Angie really wanted to do this for our family. She wanted to bless our family in this way, so we said, I was like, I just have this feeling I need to say yes. Like, this is important for her and for my family. So we said yes. She's making us a Yule cake, which is very exciting. And we're going to have some crackers. And I think she's putting some other little goodies in there for us and for the children, which is so, so kind. And I'm not sure if she watches my channel, but thank you, Angie. We are so excited to receive this very special hamper to ease the burden of all of the expenses that come with this time of year. We also have children with 3 January birthdays, so it's a very expensive time of year for us, especially when our savings for it have been depleted. So yes, very, very lucky and very fortunate to have such wonderful friends, especially ones who are pagan too and celebrate Yule as well. So after we've had our lunch, we will open the rest of our presents that we've given to each other. That we've actually given to each other, not the Holly King situation. So presents, and then we usually just watch TV. We'll watch the typical Christmas movies, and we'll play games with each other, and we'll go see our horses, because we totally believe our horses are pagan too, because you know, horses don't know about Jesus, so the horses have never read the Bible, so they wouldn't celebrate. We kind of feel they wouldn't celebrate Christmas, but they would celebrate the light coming back, because actually horses' coats change with the amount of daylight there is. So I feel like horses would, they're like, meow, they're into the hours of daylight thing, which makes me think horses are pagan too, at least mine are. So we'll go see our horses, and we might go we're sailing is kind of like caroling, but instead of in the sense of caroling, like going and trying to raise money for charity or trying to get things, we would take maybe some mulled, not necessarily mulled wine, but mulled, it's usually mulled grape juice because we want the children to be able to drink it too, mince pies, small cakes, biscuits, that sort of thing that we've made. And we would go to a family's home, maybe, depending on who the family is, and we would sing to them. Otherwise, we would just give them the things. We would like make them a small package of treats and say Merry Yule, and give them a little treat box, and then we would be on our way to the next family member or friend. That's something that we would usually do, the children and I, just on our own between Yule and Christmas, because that kind of time is then very quiet for us because Yule is over and we don't really have anything else to do. So I'm not sure we will this year, because I think most of the people that we know that celebrate Christmas are away, but we might take it to like my parents, for example, who are very very supportive of Yule. They always give gifts for Yule, so they go Yule, Christmas, whatever, whenever you want to open it, it's fine. It's kind of their stance on it. Same with my sister. My sister is probably dabbles a bit in paganism, a bit more than anyone else. Like the people that I know that aren't actually pagan, she probably dabbles in it a little bit. So yes, there you go. And on Christmas Day, the only thing that we will be doing is watching the King's Speech. That's the only thing that we'll be doing differently from a normal day. I'm actually going to get lots of work done on Christmas Day because Phil's a postman, so he's going to be off, and I am going to pretty much work all day to try and get some videos out. So because my children, as I said, my children all have January birthdays. So January is crazy for me. It's really, really busy. And I also have 2 of my grandparents have anniversaries of their deaths in January. So it can be quite emotional for me in many senses of the word, especially as this year I will have a teenager. what? So it's hard. It's a hard month in many aspects. So I'm going to try and get ahead over that Christmas period when everyone else is celebrating and the world's quiet. I am going to work my butt off on those days. And then Boxing Day, we are actually going to see my cousin and her son, who is about 18 months older than Charles. And that's very nice. We're very excited about that. We haven't seen them. We don't see them very often, maybe twice a year. So we're really excited about that. And we get to take the dogs with us because they're both dog lovers. So it's very exciting. So there we go. This was a long old video, but I've managed to get it through. I don't think I'm going to have to edit anything out because I've just chatted to you about paganism. So I'm going to get this uploaded for you because it's actually supposed to be going out today. And then I'm going to do a little bit of knitting before filming some shorts and making some Instagram posts. So, you know, it's that time of year when knitting is a craft. It's kind of weather. For me, knitting is a winter activity and I'm really excited about knitting more things. So thank you so much for watching. If you haven't already, please like and subscribe. I really enjoy your company, so please keep coming back. And if there's any videos or questions you would like answered in videos, anything like that, any topics you want me to cover, please leave them in the comments below. Let me say like, oh, hang on, you were going to do videos about this. Can we see more? One video I'm thinking of doing over the next, like, I'm going to potentially start filming it. What's today? Wednesday. Start filming it this week, maybe, is a week in the life. So there'll be small clips of from every day. Or I'm thinking of doing a daily vlog, like every day for a week. So you can see like real time. So I'll, you know, get it done and then posted. It'll probably be like, I'll film it and then it'll come out the next week on the appropriate day, if that makes sense. So please let me know, my regular viewers who comment a lot, would you like to see a week in the life that was really honest and raw? Would you like to see that? Let me know if you would. Thank you so much for watching. Take care. Bye.